Welcome to the weekly show, Yours Home Library. I'm the interviewer, Chris Johnson, and joining me today is an Afghan sensation, well-publicized writer and author of three extremely successful novels, including today's book review, The Kite Runner. Help me welcome Khaled Hussaini.
Thank you. Thank you for welcoming me here.
How are you?
I'm doing great. Fine. Thank you. How about you?
Never been better. Thank you. I want to start by asking you, how or why did you write this book?
Well, to begin with, I've always wanted to be a chef. I loved seeing my mom cook delicious food, and I wanted to do the same for other people. But because my father insisted, I went and became a doctor. Now, before I move forward, I just want to say that when I was 15 years old, I moved with my parents to the US because of the military coup that occurred in Kabul, and I was sad. I couldn't express my emotions. I had to suppress them. In the US, I lost my chest. I learned English and was taught to express what my views and ideas on certain topics were. And since then, I applied this to my writing. The first time I wrote about home, I felt a lot of weight got lifted off my chest. And I kept doing this until I mastered expressing my feelings. It reached to the point that I was able to exploit a small part of my history and create a completely different medium on which my books are based upon. That is when I realized I was done conforming to society. I'm sorry, Dad, but I want to do this. And my first book, The Kite Runner, was me exploiting small emotions I was feeling and enlarging them into a plot line.
Wow. Before we dive into the specifics of the writing, can you give the audience a brief summary of the book?
Well, yes, of course. So basically, The Kite Runner is about an Afghan child living in 1975 called Amir, who has his way through life. He wants his father to love him, and he yearns for his affection. He wants to do that because he was left out of school and wasn't like his father. And another reason that I don't want to spoil for the audience if they want to read the book. Also, his relationship with the Hazara boy is jeopardized because of discrimination against the different ethnicity and religion Hazaras were born into. Overall, it is a very intense book that shows that even if you are in a different class or a social stature, everyone goes through difficulties. But the war in Afghanistan was a war of everyone.
Yes, your book touches on many important matters such as ethnicity, race, religion, sectarianism, family, war, gender, rape, you name it. How do you think this reflects your upbringing and the ideology you lived in?
So, I think my upbringing is different to any other Afghan kid. I was born into a more liberal part of Afghanistan, and my father was a diplomat in the Afghan Foreign Ministry. And we moved to the United States when Afghanistan was hit with a bloody communist coup, which gave me the feelings of homesickness portrayed in Amir moving to the US. Also, I was able to see a clear difference between Hazaras and Pashtuns in our society, which is why I emphasized on that point and made it personal. Also, the fact that Amir wants to be a writer in the US is completely taken from my own personal life.
Yes, this is very important, especially since many people have critiqued the book and said it was a very poor reflection of what actually happened in Afghanistan.
Okay, so yes, I agree. I don't know exactly what happened in my country, but I feel with it. I resonate with it, and if people are going to criticize it for its historical accuracy, then they are the ones who have lost the point of the book and kept focusing on such trivial matters. It's all about perspective.
Very powerful. Strong.
Thank you.
Let's talk about the style of the writing.
Yes.
It has a very simplistic language, yet it portrays a huge meaning.
Yes, I wanted to everyone to read the book and be able to read it. I think part of the reason why I felt it had a good description is that I used Afghan jargon and words to be able to set a scene in people's mind. I wanted people to see the beauty of Afghanistan that I saw when I was young. That is why I described everything and left nothing undescribed. I wanted people of all ages to resonate with the book. So by creating a vivid vivid images of places, people. I made it local to Afghanistan. And through that, people will know what the current situation is, or have it at least in their mind. It will bring forward the conflict and publicize it. As I said in the book, there was a line that sticks with me. There are a lot of children in Afghanistan, but little childhood there. This was of major importance to me and in the message behind the book itself.
How were the characters' immigrant experience similar or different to your own immigrant experience?
Well, mine was hard, leaving our home, the garden, the people and the culture. It was even harder to retain our own traditions in such a divergent place. You can see that in the book when Amir and his father and other Afghanis keep their rituals, the handshakes, how they respect one another, and how Afghanis get married.
Why did you choose the title The Kite Runner? What was its significance over other possible titles?
Well, the Afghan kites with their glass strings symbolize the contrast between beauty and violence, simultaneously representing Afghanistan and the half-brothers, Amir and Hassan. The two main kite fights in the novel, the tournament Amir wins and the one at the end of the book, not only represent Amir and Hassan, but also symbolize the juxtaposition of their roles. For at the end, Amir has become the kite runner.
Well, thank you for sharing this with us. It has been a pleasure, and I'm sure many people are affected by the story of the kite runner, your story, and the Khaled Hosseini Foundation in your home country, which provides humanitarian assistance to the people of Afghanistan.